I will increase what you have. And this we said it many times because we all the time when we do fundraising, we mention these verses, we mention the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially in multiplying the charity. طبعاً the best example that Allah gave in the Quran and used the word مثل الذين, that's the parable, the similitude, the parable of those who give in charity. He said مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة. Most everyone of you know this, that the similitude of a person who gives in charity is like a grain, one grain of like corn or a grain of rice. When you plant this grain, it's one grain that when you plant it, it shoots like a plant. And then Allah says, كَمَثَلْ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلْ. He said, as if it gives you 7 years. You know what a bushel of a year of corn or durum or whatever, it's a huge thing. Might be hundreds of pieces in it. Like that one thing that you put, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made. He said, كَمَثَلْ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلْ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ. This is the minimum, by the way. He said, as if you have a, what you call a corn, bushel or something, and then it has 100 seeds. One seed makes 100, makes 7 years, and each one of them has 100. So you have how many? 700. Mind you, this is not the maximum. This is actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. يعني when Allah says you have 7 years of corn and then each one of them has 100, that's 7 by 100. But Allah didn't say that. Allah said Allah might multiply it. يعني it might be 7 to the power 100 or 100 to 7 power. And you saw the big difference between the two of them. So on the one hand, this is what the shaitan does. On the other hand, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. So here in this part, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, واتلو عليهم نبأ الذي آتيناه آياتنا فانسلخ منها فاتبعه الشيطان. That's the sequence. فكان من الغاوين. The person who actually were completely distracted. By the way, let me complete the verse that we mentioned about charity. When Allah talks about the shaitan that he promises you poverty and does this, he said, والله واسع عليم. Then he said, يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء. ومن يؤتى الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا. وما يذكر إلا أولي الألباب. He said none but the most smart people who think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does in terms of multiplying their charity and so on. And he said يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء. Allah chooses people to give them wisdom. And Allah said if Allah give you wisdom, Allah has given you everything. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you حكمة, Allah gave you everything. يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤتى الحكمة and whoever is given it فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا. كثيرا to Allah is limitless. وما يذكر إلا أولي الألباب. And then he closes the verse by saying none but those of intelligence, people are smart, who really think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. Here is the opposite. He said فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين. One, he will be accompanied by the shaitan, and the shaitan will completely distract him and take him away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, ولو شئنا رفعناه بها. يعني, what Allah gave him of knowledge or wealth, Allah could have elevated him, because with that, we go to elevations in paradise. We said this many times, that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, الجنة, الجنة is not one place. Otherwise, it's not be fair for people who give their life to Allah, give them their life, martyr them, the people who fought with Rasulullah, the people who took all this and so on, will not be equal to them. And if we are all put in one place, that will not be fair for the other people, because some people do most of the other. So the Prophet said, Al-Jannah mi'at daraja. Like paradise is 100 ranks. And this mentioned also in the Quran indirectly. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wa lil-akhira, that's the akhira, akbaru darajatin wa akbaru tafdila. And that's a wide variety between whom placed with. And the Prophet described it this way. He said, Al-Jannah mi'at daraja. Paradise is 100 ranks. Ma bayna darajatin. Yani you have 100 ranks. Between one rank and the other is between the heavens and the earth. It's unimaginable. And he said, ma bayna darajatin, ma bayna as-sama'. In one hadith actually said, ma bayna as-sama'i wal-ard, between the heavens and the earth. The other one he said, between al-mashriq and al-maghrib, between the east and the west. And this is why the Firdaus and all of these things that we read about in the Quran, they say the highest stages, we mentioned this many times are the four levels that Allah spoke. And you have 100 ranks. The top first ones are النبيين, the prophets and the messengers. الصديقين, people who are truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. الشهداء, the people who give themselves in martyrdom. والصالحين. Then you go down. So Allah ranks people between one another and moves them up when they give charity. يعني the more you give, the more you get elevated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says here, لو شئنا رفعناه بها. That's what we like. We lift him up in paradise. ولكنه أخلد إلى الأرض. He doesn't want to go out of this earth. And the earth, it ends with death. يعني people who don't have any connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the end of their life is this life. It's finished. There is nothing beyond that. But for believers, طبعا الحمد لله, we try to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate us in paradise, to increase our ranks there, and so on. So he say, ولكنه أخلد واتبع هو. أخلد إلى الأرض واتبع هو. Then he gave the parable. فمثله كمثل الكلب. That this person who has been honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with this knowledge, with faith and so on, and then he reverts. Because many people يعني get to that point and then they leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, فمثله, and this is why the problem is so ugly, يعني. He said, كمثل الكلب. It's like a dog. إن تحمل عليه يلهث. Like a dog, if you push him or you try it, he will keep, is it panting? Yeah, panting. And if you leave him, he will do the same thing. So you see the dog sitting, he will still keep, يعني, he does not stop. ذلك مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, is the similitude or the parable of people who disbelieved or denied our verses. And then he says to the Prophet, فقصص القصص. Tell them all, you know, all these stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about all kinds of people who do that. He says, فقصص القصص لعلهم يتفكرون. So that they might be thinking, that might reflect on it. Now, he says here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, ولكنه أخلد الأرض, or he actually went, instead of going up, he's still going down. Then he will end up what? In a grave, and that's the end of it. He says, on top of this also, because these are the people who follow their desires. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, even now, by the way, one of the biggest problems that we have, especially for our kids, between two things. Many times you hear this in the khutbahs and so on. They say, between shubuhat and shahawat, like desires and doubts. These are the things that distract people from the deen. The desires will attract the person. Like we are full of desires. And this is why many times we said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Like it says, as for the one who is able, actually he, الخاف means he fears. المقام is the position of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like Allah has several maqamat for us. Like when we talk about maqam al-iman, maqam al-ibadah, maqam al-ta'a, maqam this, maqam. Like there are things that Allah told us. Like we know all these things. But the highest of them is that of faith. Of believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin it with, and obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he says, if you look at that, فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ, because of that, then نَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. And then you restrain yourself from the desires. What takes people to hellfire? Mostly desires. And whoever is able to restrain and control these desires, Allah said he will go to paradise. فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Just a formula. That as for the ones is able to contain, to restrain, to restrict his desires, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate the way for him to paradise. So on the one hand, we are struggling with these desires. And desires, you can imagine. Yani, all what you see around you, especially now with social media, with all of this, you see the worst. Yani, things that you could not have imagined people doing, it's become like open. Everything is open. Yeah, and things that are really bad. So these are the things that will distract the people from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other one, of course, is like doubts. People have doubts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They doubt about the Quran, doubt about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says it. He says here, إن صفته, that is like example or similitude, is like this dog. In what? The dog is in his loneliness, and then he is the waste you can imagine, and then he cannot stop panting this. يعني the things are always him. And this is why he says, شبه المنسلخ بآيات الله بالكلب دون سائر السباع. يعني Allah used the dog, not using any other one. There are so many animals Allah could have used. But the waste of them, because the dog doesn't have a heart. It doesn't have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, like, you know, when somebody is reckless, doesn't care, in colloquial language, we say, قلب ميت. يعني he doesn't have any feeling. He doesn't have anything to do it. And this is why he doesn't, like, the dog is known for this. It is. So he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for instance, he mentioned this verse because he says, although the dog can be trained, you know, dogs can be trained for hunting. They can be trained for this sacrament, but they can revert. And in many cases that we have, that people trust the dog so much and all of a sudden it flips. And people even now don't understand that. And Allah said this in the Quran. In the Quran, by the way, he mentioned this verse in Surah Al-Ma'idah. وَمَا عَلَّمْتُمْ مِنَ الْجَوَارِحِ مُكَلِّبِينَ تُعَلِّمُونَهُمْ مِمَّا عَلَّمَكُمُ اللَّهِ فَكُلُوا مِمَّا أَمْسَكْنَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَاذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. This is again, you just have to pause it. This is about hunting. You know, in Islam, it's allowed to hunt an animal. Even if it dies. يعني say for instance, you can use, people used to use an arrow. And Allah mentioned this in the Quran, تَنَالُهُ رِمَاحُكُمْ. Like if people used to, you know, now people use bullets or shoot things to do them and use dogs. Now, the rules of hunting in Islam, Allah said, مَا عَلَّمْتُمْ. يعني say, if you have a dog and you mark this dog and then you throw him, because normally when you mark a dog, you know this dog is going to hunt an animal, hit a rabbit or run after something. Sometimes the impact can kill the animal. It's still that animal is halal for eating. So long as this is the dog that actually you sent. And there are rules, they say, for instance, too many scenarios, A, B, and C. Let me go for A. You have a rabbit and you have a dog. You name the dog and then you send it after the rabbit. And the dog captures the rabbit, or by the hitting it, it dies. Because that dog is marked and you know this is your dog, then that's, you can eat that meat for it. But if there are two dogs, one is yours and another dog, both of them came, you don't know which one, you don't eat that dog. Because you don't know which one does the killing, the one that you mark or the one that is not. Or they say if the rabbit falls, say in a ditch and gets drowned. Because you send the dog, yes, the dog, but you don't know whether the actual death happened because of the impact or because of the drowning. So, and the same thing for bullets, something for arrows. They say if you have an arrow, normally you name the arrow, you say Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, and send it after the animal. Now, if the animal dies, and mostly smaller animals die from that, and if it dies as a result of the arrow that you named, then this is halal. But if it falls and two animals comes or two arrows, anything that gets in it, that renders it otherwise. So Allah says, مَا عَلَّمْتُمْ مِنَ الْجَوَارِحِ مُكَلِّبِينَ تُعَلِّمُونَهُنَّ مِمَّا عَلَّمَكُمُ اللَّهِ فَكُلُوا مِمَّا أَمْسَكْنَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَاذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. يعني, whatever they capture for you, you can eat them, and then remember to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. He says, جانب ذلك, this is the word he said, إن الكلب مشهور بالخسة. Like, it's a very, like, humiliating animal that you have. And he says also, it's known the dog is one of the worst impure animals. يعني the, what we call the sliver of the dog, the thing that we have. So this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give this example for it as the worst. And the verse that he says, كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ إِنْ تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَيْهَا أَوْ تَتْرُكُ يَعْزَ ذَلِكَ مَثَلُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَثَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. He says, أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أيضا, he said that Allah told us in the Quran that among the things that, by the way, I don't know whether this is true because I never raised the dog. He says, The dog is known. Anyone have a dog? They said that it's the only animal that keeps smelling itself like this back, يعني, and tries to lick it. This is strange. I didn't know that. This is the first time I read this. Yeah. And he says this is why there are certain things طبعا known about the dog. One of the things he mentioned here, he said, for instance, if you throw a stone at the dog will run and try to eat it because he thinks there is something, يعني anything that's thrown to it, even a stone, the stone that he says for it. And this is why he says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this worst example for the person whom Allah guides. And then, and this happened طبعا during the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq when people left Islam and so on and so on. He said they went back from this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says also, because the dog has, by the way, they say that among the animals that he says here, he says this panting, if he stopped it, he might die. He cannot, as if he's breathing through that. So this part of what he says, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about him. And also, he says, most of the time, the people who are like this, they don't rest. They don't have rest because they become so worried. They get very confused. They don't know what they are doing. And then they keep going back and forth with themselves so that they don't come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says also, إِن تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَى الْهُدَى لَا يَتْبَعُونَكُمْ سَوَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ. يعني he says these are the people that if you even call them back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will not come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, طبعا نظر في سليف السد السورة, we said, سَوَانُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنذَرْتُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So to them it doesn't matter whether you call them or not. He says, and this is why, this was given by a person in Bani Israel. He mentioned this story. His name is Bal'am. This is a Jewish name. He says this the person that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him. He became a Muslim. And then he betrayed everything that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave for him and became the worst person. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned him by saying, وَلَوْ شَأْنَا وَرَفْنَاهُ وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَّا الْأَرْضِ. يعني Allah brought him from disbelief, from misguidance, from being lost, but he didn't stick to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this regard. He says, أَنَّ هَذَا النَّمُوجَدْ This Bal'am, actually, give more. He says, Bal'am ibn Awra. He says he became an example of people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, and then they go and turn on their back not to follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. He said, and this applies to anyone, especially the people of the book, like from the Jews and the Christians, who accepted Islam with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they are hypocrites, basically. Immediately after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they went back, they refused to pay the zakah for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, and Abu Bakr had to fight them, so that, and there's lots of things that were said about this. He says, تناقل المسلمون والمفسرون قصته من التوراة. يعني, by the way, this man was also mentioned again in the Torah from Rambo Islami. He said he was one of the followers of Musa. This is another, he said, Bul'am there and Bul'am this one. He said he was a follower of Musa alayhi salam. And then he sent him, like, just, you know, the Prophet used to send ambassadors. You know, Mu'az ibn Jamal went to Yemen, these people. So he was sent by Musa alayhi salam. But instead of going and delivered the message that Musa gave him, he went and started calling people contrary to the religion for this. He says, and in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this applies to all the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the guidance, but they came back. He mentioned here Ubayy ibn Salt. قال عنه عبد الله بن عمر. He said there was a person by the name Ubayy ibn Salt. He said, أن الله سبحانه وتعالى, when this revelation came, most of the Muslims, like especially people like Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Abbas, they said he meant that person because exactly he did what Allah سبحانه وتعالى did him. He said this man, Ibn Salt, قالت آمن بكل معجزات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وآياته وبراهينه وكان دائما يقول ذلك. And this man reached the point, instead of him by himself being convinced, he used to preach this for other people. And he says, اجتمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عليه, يعني the Prophet used to trust this man and put it on him, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah, instead of like trying to elevate him. The man went gone. There is another person, he says his name is Amir al-Sayfi. كان يلبس محوس الرهبان. He says this one, he used also during the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to talk to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he became a Muslim. But immediately after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, he turned back from Islam. And then he started writing. He said, كان يكتب للمنافقين. Like the hypocrites and so on. To discourage them even from rethinking about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the man that he initiated what is known. You know, in the history of Islam, there is a mosque that's built, which is called Masjid al-Durar. Yeah, this masjid was not built to worship Allah, but actually to destroy the Muslims from within. And he says this man, the person. And this is why he said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جاءه الأحي بذلك. Like the masjid al-Usri al-Taghwa, you know the verse, حق أن تقوم فيه, like Allah said to the Prophet. And actually Allah told the Prophet, this is not just a normal masjid. It's not meant so that people can use it for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet, he said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمر بهدمه فهدم. وقال أن الله سبحانه وتعالى قال كما يروى سعيد بن مبيد أن آية الأعراف نزلت في these people. Because these are the people who left رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and meant for other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذلك مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا. This is the similitude or the parable of all the people who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is not restricted to the time of Rasulullah or the time of Musa. Throughout history, you find people like this. Even today, you know, there's with all this flood of YouTube and so on. You get many people from Egypt, from Syria, from different Muslim countries. And they come out blatantly say what they don't. And sometimes they are very wicked. Yani they say things. Somebody actually said this and then died. And then the whole issue became a big issue because he denied everything that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. He said, وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ كَمْ مِنْ إِنسَانٍ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the sight, gave him the light, gave him the to see, he gave him to hear, he gave them the intelligence, he gave them all of this. And instead of using it, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they used it for the contrary. This is why this emphasis in this word, فَقْصُصْ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So it commands the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam that these are the people that you have to be careful about and the like of these people that we have. He says, فَهَذِهِ الْقِصَرِ لِرِيَالِ مُتْشَابِهِينَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَأَنَّ الْآيَاتِ like all these verses that came to us so that we can reflect on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said and then to keep ourselves safe away from these people. He said also this story of the person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with wealth and he used the wealth exactly to the contrary. And instead of using it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we use it for other people. And some people do that, by the way. Yani, instead of using it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, use it other than that. He said, وأن الله سبحانه وتعالى, like Allah revealed so many things in the Quran about the universe, about cosmos, about all of this. Allah gave people a lot of knowledge so that they can see it, but they didn't benefit from all these things that Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave them. He says, ثم قال سبحانه وتعالى ساء مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا وأنفسهم كانوا يظلمون. The worst type of people are these, the people who disbelieve, they deny what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and they do injustice to no one but to themselves. Like a person who leaves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not harm Allah. You know, in the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this hadith Qudsi, and we said the hadith al-Qudsi is that it is a text that given by Rasulullah. The words are from Rasulullah, but the meaning is from Allah. So the Prophet used to say in Allah, that Allah said so. And he said in the famous Hadith Qudsi, he said, Ya Ibadi, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على أتقى رجل ما زاد ذلك في الملك شيء ولو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على أفجر قلب رجل واحد ما نقص ذلك في ملك شيء إلا كما ينقص المخياط إذا نزل البحر. But this hadith means Allah says, if everyone, every human being, every creation, every creature, they stood up and worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will not increase Allah in anything. And if all the people, all of them, disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rejected this deen of Allah, أولكم وآخركم من the beginning the end all of these people that will not decrease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mighty it will not decrease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power it will not decrease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's honor unless the Prophet gave the example as if you dip a needle in the ocean and take it out it doesn't take anything like the needle he compared it with this one so he says وهذا التقبيح يعني this kind of thing الله سبحانه وتعالى قبح صفاتهم he gave that in their descriptions in the way they are الله سبحانه وتعالى make it worse for them and he says all of this الله سبحانه وتعالى did it for us so that we can really reflect on the bounties the ni'mah that الله سبحانه وتعالى gave us that we are safe from these things you know there are some people I remember one of the incidents that happened Some people who are, alhamdulillah, they're very pious people. They just can't believe that somebody disbelieves in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they can't imagine it. Especially if the person is like an intelligent person, a professor or somebody. People say, this man doesn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man, dear brother from the Sudan. They said this happened in the Sudan, an incident. They said a man came from a village. And then people are talking about it and they said, oh, this person doesn't believe in Allah. They said the man fainted. How come he doesn't believe in Allah? And to him, it's unimaginable with all the signs, with all the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you. So he says, in هذا المثل, ينير الطريق لذوي البصائر. And it actually, it lights the way for people who want to follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then it contains their desires as well. Give them the direction so that they can... worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe him. And he says this also leads to the fear of Allah. Like the more you know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you become conscious of Allah, the more you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah used the word all the time, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ for that. And he says, وَلِذَلِكَ نَحْنُ نَتَضَرَّعْ إِلَى اللَّهِ بِالدُّعَى يعني all the time we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer, we try to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like to forgive our sins, to leave us from all what we have. And he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says this, that these people should come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because guidance basically comes from Allah and comes to a person who wants to be guided. يعني الذين اهتدوا دادهم هدى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this. يعني if you make it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you for guidance. He said, وَقَدْ عَلَّمَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ And this is very important. عَلَّمَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَن نَتَعَوَّدْ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا يعني even the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام is known that when he used to stand in the minbar on the khutbah, after he opens it, he will say what? اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا That, oh Allah, we seek refuge or protection from you from our own shortcomings or evil deeds. He said, عَلَّمَنَ ذَلِكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَكَانَ يَأْتِي ذَلِكَ بَعْدَ الْحَمْدِ وَالثَّنَاءِ يعني, you know, the Prophet on the member starts with إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ وَالنَّحْمَدِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ whatever it is. Then he will say, اللَّهُمَّ إِنَّا نَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا And he said this to teach us too. If this is the Prophet asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect him from all his own shortcomings and evil doings, then what about us? And most of the things by the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says is for us to save us from all these things about our own self. And this is the worst. Actually, they say if you can overcome your own weaknesses, your own shortcomings, then you can overcome anything else, and that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said for us. He says, وَمِنْ رِقَّةِ الدِّينِ Like the deen, actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time remind us of who we are. We can sin. Nobody is an angel. And this is why, by the way, يعني Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that if you people don't sin, Allah will send people on earth to sin, and then Allah will ask them for forgiveness for them, and Allah will increase them in the reward for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. جاء في الحديث الشريف عبد الرحمن بن عوف قال أنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ما يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. If Allah wants to do good to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you in knowledge and will increase you in the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on that. Because the people who truly fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are people of knowledge. Allah said this in the Quran. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء. The person who people who are most fearing of Allah, people who have the knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, وَأَنَّ الَّذِي يَعِيشُ بِذَلِكَ And a person who fears or lives with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always find himself at peace with his own self. His own self. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it clear for us that Jahannam or the hellfire are for people who disbelieve in Allah and people who don't have any fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely says they don't think, they don't contemplate, they don't have hearts, they don't have brains. In the Quran, Allah said, وَلَغَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمْ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ Jahannam will be a place for the jinn and the ins. لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا Like their hearts do not contemplate for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them. وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا These people, as if they don't have eyes, they don't have. وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ These are just like animals. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلْ They are worse than an'am. Because the animal Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them as they are. But the human Allah created him, gave him the mind, gave him the brain, gave him all these faculties with which he can reflect and we can think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, وَأَتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْعِلْمُ وَلَكِنَّهُ انْسَلَخَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ يعني people Allah gave them the knowledge, gave them the way to do it, and so on. And he says, أَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى says to us, مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ These are the people who are the loser for this. He goes on to say, he says, يعني أن الله سبحانه وتعالى gave him the idrak, and gave them the means to comprehend, the means to think, the means to think, but they didn't use that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we gave them ears, but they don't hear with it. جعلنا لهم سمعا وأبصارا وأفئدة فما أغنى عنهم سمعهم ولا أبصارهم ولا أفئدتهم من شيء إذ كانوا يجحدون بآيات الله. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them all these faculties, but they didn't make use of it. And this was Allah again in another verse in the Quran, this is Surah Al-Anfal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them again as animals. So like animals. He said, إِنَّ شَرَّ الدَّوَابِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ The worst, dawab is cattle. عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَصُمُّ الْبُقْمِ Like people who are deaf and dumb, and they don't think, they don't. وَلَعَلِمَ اللَّهُ فِيهُمْ خَيْرًا لَأَسَمَعَهُمْ وَلَوْ أَسْمَعَهُمْ لَتَوَلَّوْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ That Allah, if he knows that there's good in them, Allah would have given them this. But even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to them, then they will not use it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, وَلِذَٰلِكَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى دَعَ مَطِيَّةَ الْإِنسَانِ لِلْآخِرَةِ Like if you want to go to hell, to paradise, then you try to restrain, as I said, yourself, and then you start keeping away from shirk, everything that will drag you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, yamalatu tashbih, he used the word, this in Arabic language, these things are more. He called it yamalatu tashbih wa diqqati fi bayan al-dalal wal-mushrikeen wa taqbihal. He said that the beauty of this picture that Allah gave us to us is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us how bad it could be for a person to be misguided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and especially if they suspend all the faculties that Allah gave them to think and comprehend. That finishes this part, inshallah, from the parable. أقول قبلي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم استغفروه إنه غفور رحيم صلى الله على نبينا محمد. You are right on time. نعم. As if he peeled it off from his heart. Yeah, like as if you peel something from something. Especially, they say precious things, the skin is so tight on them, it's not like easily removed. You know, if you have a sheep or a goat or something, people skin it fast. But there are certain things, like certain types of animals, a fish and so on, you can hardly skin it because it goes right on that. So this way the silah becomes more tight here. طبعا the character, the general character. لأن طبعا الكلب here is general. It's not like specific dogs. This is why he said that they have يعني الدناءة, الخسة, الذلة, المهانة. يعني الكلب is very humiliated. And especially this description of like it gives you a very bad impression about this animal. It is restless. Somebody saying something, sorry. Same. How people used to hunt with all kinds of things. يعني even if you have a stone, you say Bismillah, Allah Akbar, and hit it. If it is an animal, هو طبعا it might die, it might not die, right? Sometimes you just suspend it. But even if it dies, because it's already named, right? You said Bismillah and you throw it, then that's it. But if there are two stones or two animals or two arrows or two bullets, then you don't know which one did the killing. So you cannot eat it. If you hit any animal you hit, this is what Allah used in the Quran when he spoke about the halal and haram. طيب حرم عليكم الميتة والدم من دين الله سبحانه وتعالى described الميتة by الموقوزة المتردية. He gave all the categories. But at the end of it, and inshallah round it up for you, he says, إلا ما زكيتم. إلا ما زكيتم. Except the one that you make the tazkiyah for. Which means if you are on the road and you had an animal, so long as the animal did not die from that hit, you can catch it and still do it. Or an animal, this is called al-mawquza, something that's hit. Or al-mutaraddiya, like even if an animal, say, it's on a ceiling of or a roof, and then it fell and it died as a result. Before it dies, you reach it. And the way the Prophet ﷺ says, you know how it is still alive, he said, if she makes a sign like it moves its tail or moves its eyes, then that's alive. If you catch it, then you can still slaughter it. And this, by the way, this is interesting too. Someone brought it. Here now, there is this issue that has been raised recently about machine. You know, we used to license or certify this thing with the machines. And then a group of brothers, basically from subcontinent, they came and said, no, 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 this is machine slaughter, it's not halal. It has to be hand slaughter. The argument actually is false. Then when you kill when you slaughter an animal, you don't slaughter it with your hand. You have to use a machine, right? You still have a knife. Now, all what the machines are doing in this large scale production, this maple lodge, for instance, they used to produce for every shift that we had Muslims for, 250,000 chicken per shift. So it can't, and it's impossible to get people to do that. So they have these revolvers. But we made sure that this will come, their blessers to say Bismillah, Allahu Akbar, put it on it, it goes. It's cut by the machine. So when they raised the argument, they said, listen, the machine can kill an animal. And if for hunting, you actually send the machine to kill the animal. Am I right? And you don't do it by your own hand. You don't take it out. So that was a thing that came, and still, I think this argument is going by. And some people still think that you have to have machine, hand slaughtered. They say not machine slaughtered. Doesn't make sense. Inshallah. Right? Jazakum Allah khairan. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.